Just making sure, because it all ties together at some point, you know, when you've watched too many.
It's 90 minutes, so it's like there's a lot to fit in there.
Yeah, for sure.
Hey everyone, welcome back into the recap Game of Thrones edition. Jake Kringschreifels, Case Keenum here with me. We're going to break down Season 8, Episode 4. And let's just get to... Let's get to the opening there. You big fan of the theme song?
Yeah, I love it, man. Somebody was telling me, I guess, I binged watched it, but you fast forward through some of that. But I guess, does it kind of allude to where most of the action is going to be based on, the...
What is in the scenes?
Yeah, some of the animation. Yeah, some of those scenes. So
I think it updates.
Yeah.
Each time you see it, it's new.
It's a little different. I try to look at something different. This season's, I guess, is really cool, man. It's cool how
they updated it for the last one.
Do that animation. It's pretty neat.
Let's jump right into it and get to best moment.
Mm-hmm.
I got a few candidates for you.
Yeah.
Let's start at the beginning, the burning the dead.
Yeah.
Very solemn moment. Props to them for being able to get everybody onto those big halos, I guess, silos.
Because
that must have been a cleanup job for the ages.
Yeah, Jon Snow's speech, definitely wanted to go back and watch, but it was cool. A cool start to the episode, obviously, with all the people that went down.
This was a brief one, but Rhaegal, the dragon, getting killed in midair. That was a little strange, though. I'm like, how do you not see those guys from way up in the air?
Yeah, I was surprised, too, because it was kind of you didn't think it was going to be a tense scene. I mean, they're just traveling, and then all of a sudden... the dragon's down. Now there's only one dragon left. I mean, is that going to be the end of the dragons forever again?
There's a question if there's been an egg laid somewhere.
Really?
Yeah, I've seen that too.
Yeah.
Euron's face at the end of the trailer for next week, he's looking up and he's shocked.
Yeah.
Some people think there might be another dragon or maybe...
I did see that.
Armor. That's another one, too.
Ooh.
That would be interesting. Armor for a dragon. The last moment I had was the surrender request, just because it's so tense and Cersei's way up top.
Yeah.
And I think it's a little silly, the amount of Unsullied that she has in her army to then request a surrender just doesn't seem like a real request.
Especially with all those new weapons that they now fashioned to the wall and had pointing at them. I was like, if they really did decide just to go ahead and attack.
Episode MVP. I had a few for this one. I started out with Lord Varys.
Mm-hmm.
Hasn't been a big player in this season so far, but he finally now is back to the scheming ways, and he's talking to Tyrion about a lot of different strategies and whose side he wants to be on. I just thought that was a big episode for him.
And he stepped up to Daenerys as well, right?
Yeah.
Like he actually was like, hey, I think you're doing the wrong thing here.
I like Gendry in this one. Now, he gets rejected by Arya in his proposal, which is a brutal one, but he also gets crowned Lord of Storm's End by Daenerys.
I like that. A really good moment paired with a bad moment right next to it where Arya's like, no, I don't want that.
Right. I mean, you could even toggle that to Brienne and Jaime. Really good moment.
Yeah.
Toggle by a really bad moment.
Exactly.
Yeah, those Baratheons, they get turned down by Stark. Right.
The last episode MVP, Cersei, just because, I mean, when you see her and she's completely in control and she's got a lot of confidence right now. I think she's a little too...
She's incredible.
They fought the war up north for her and now she gets to flex her muscle a little bit.
You forget, you get so wrapped up in, what do they call it, the Great War against the White Walkers that, they've been preparing and sitting at home, not just waiting for them to come.
Best quote, let's go to Arya. I'm not a lady, I never have been. That's not me. That was pretty good to get into.
Yeah, that was a good one. And when you said that too, thinking about when Arya and the Hound are heading south, when he asks, I don't plan on coming back. And she's like, me neither. And then what's the other one that he says? He's like, I don't plan on this. And she's like, me neither. Oh, yeah. I don't like crowds. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like crowds.
He's like, I don't like crowds. She's like, me neither. He's like, I don't plan on coming back. She's like, me neither.
Yeah, they have an interesting bond together.
I know.
I would like to see them take down the mountain.
Yeah. See, I was thinking, talking about battles coming up, who's the mountain going to fight? Is the mountain going to fight Grey Worm because of Missandei?
Oh, that's a good
question. Is the mountain going to fight the Hound?
Also, two more.
Quickly, shout out to everybody for keeping their composure after Missandei gets... I was thinking, I was like, everybody just relax. I know it was huge, but chill out for a second.
Yeah.
Because you can make a really bad decision right here.
Yeah.
As mad as she was, Daenerys kind of turned around and everybody kind of kept it inside. And I was happy that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That fueled the fire.
Let's go really quickly. Predictions and questions. We already had one question. How will the mountain get defeated?
Yeah.
If he does. Is Bran going to help them out in this battle too in some way? I mean, I don't know. He was very helpful in some ways with the Night King, but not sure he's really needed anymore.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, we were talking in the locker room about this too. The original Night King was made to help, right? Like supposed to be good, but turned out being bad. Like, could there be another Night King made that's actually a good, like somebody, for instance, like a Jon Snow who doesn't want power, doesn't want, you know, he's like constantly trying to, you know, I don't want to be king, I don't want power. And he's actually true, like has a good heart. So could he be a Night King and actually help?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Impossible question before we go. Who in your mind sits on the Iron Throne at the end of this season?
You know, I don't know. I've gone all over. I mean, obviously I'm going to root for Jon Snow and his queen, you know, Khaleesi there, you know, to rule together. I could really see like an Arya, and then I could see like a twist where like Tyrion winds up. You know, like just like he's just, I don't know, he's just slowly like always just made his way into it. I don't know. I mean, that'd be a long shot, but yeah. I don't know.
Maybe that would finally make Tywin proud of them. Who knows?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we will find out maybe next week, the big battle. Thanks for tuning in.